this earth is being bombarded by demonic power, the powers of hell, and they're coming now as if the Holy Spirit is withdrawing that holding power, that restraining power, and pulling back and allowing this mantle of deception to fall upon mankind. 2 Thessalonians 2 says that because they loved not the truth, but had pleasure or love of a lie, that God will send them strong delusion, that they should believe a lie and be damned. Listen carefully to me. You cannot believe what you hear. You cannot believe what you see. You cannot believe what you think you know, because we're living in a time of horrible deception. And that deception is everywhere. It's in the media. It's in the educational system. It's in the government. It's in the churches. It's throughout society. It permeates everything that has to do with what makes up American culture and the cultures of this world. The only place you can go to for safety is the Word of God. Judge everything by the Scriptures. Please listen to what I'm saying. Things are about to change. We know of the mass shootings, the killings. We know what happened in Newtown, Connecticut. We know what happened in Aurora, Colorado. And I have a list here of all the other shootings that have taken place in the last few years. And so, my friend, this is happening. But why is it happening? We have an anti-gun crusade taking place in the nation right now, as if the guns were to blame. You know, as if you could blame a gun. Find something and blame it. Of course, it's an agenda. It's an agenda that's been in motion for a long time. They just seized this opportunity to push it and further it. But the real problem lies deeper than that. The problem lies in what's motivating these killers. What kind of culture? Not only that, but the drug part is never mentioned. The fact that they're on these mind-altering drugs. The Bible says in the book of Revelation that neither repented they of their sorceries. The word for sorcery in the Greek word is pharmakia. Please understand me. I'm not telling you that your pharmacist is a witch. I'm not telling you that because you take drugs that you are in witchcraft. That's not what I'm saying at all. But note carefully, the source of the word is pharmakia. Literally taken from Greek into English. That's all they did. They transliterated it. It's pharmacy. The word meant 2,000 years ago to take drugs and use them in a spiritual state. It brought you into a spiritual relationship. Anytime you put yourself in an altered state of consciousness, you can bring spirits into yourself, into your body. There's where the problem lies. It's bad enough that you take a mind-altering drug. That's bad enough. Where you're out of your senses. Where committing suicide is an epidemic in this country. I don't know if you've paid any attention to it, but so many of these drugs that they advertise for liver and for the heart and for your kidneys and for cholesterol and for this and for that, for depression, they give some of the warnings and they tell you that suicide is one of the things associated with the taking of this drug. They have a profound effect on people. Drugs are given by the Lord God to help you, but they can also be used in a bad way. And I'm afraid that the pharmakia that they're talking about in Revelation is the usage of drugs to induce altered states of consciousness, to get you into a spiritual state. And my friend, that's exactly what's going on. And I'll tell you something else too. I don't know who all's behind the proliferation of drugs in our country. For example, Juarez, Mexico. How many of you know that that's a Mexican town? They've got 1.5 million people in Juarez. It's on a border down there. And they say it is one of the major routes of drugs coming into this country. What most people don't know is that 400 women, their dead bodies, have been found lying strewn around in Juarez, Mexico over the last few years. And they don't know who's doing this. At first they thought it was a serial killer, but now because of the number 400, they're beginning to take another look at it. And they think it may possibly be drug pushers, the ones who carry the drugs into the country. These people, one of their religions is Santeria. Santeria, the religion of Santeria, is where you call upon Satan and give him a sacrifice in order for him to give you power to get what you want. They want money. They want power. And so they sacrifice women. They've offered up 400 women on their altar so that they could put money in their pocket and push their dope into this country. Drugs are a big deal, friends. Everybody in this house at one time or another, your life is going to be infected. It's going to be touched by the use of illegal drugs or the abuse of drugs, prescription drugs or whatever. Drugs, according to the scripture, certainly can be set in a bad context because they can bring on a spiritual reality that you don't want. And so these killers, Adam Lanza, a lot of people suspect that he was on drugs. They know the killers out there at Columbine were on, one of them certainly was on drugs, and they named the drug he was on. And the other one, they won't let you see his medical record. They won't let you see what he was on. And they went in there and started killing those kids in Columbine. Drugs definitely are being used today to push people toward what they want in a one-world government. Drugs and spirits.